City of Mosaics, the Pearl of the Southeast, Gaziantep, with its mysterious history, where different civilizations, races, cultures, and religions have come together and synthesized with each other. It is the largest city of the East and the sixth biggest city of Turkey. With its handicrafts, rich cookery, pistachios, baklava, Zeugma, the ancient city which is known worldwide, historical ruins, natural beauty, and cultural values, Gaziantep is an important city, not only for Turkey, but also the Middle Eastern region. Gaziantep, throughout its 5,600-year history, has been and remains a center of trade and culture. From the castle, boroughs, hammams, mosques, and tombs from antiquity, to the industrial areas, shopping centers, touristic trips, and resorts of modern times. Gaziantep, while remaining a city of cultural handicrafts and craftsmen whom retain their popularity today, continues to be a leader. There are about 300 Bronze Age burrows and also one of the oldest settlements of the world, which is the ancient city of Dolce, that dates back to 6000 BC, with natural caves from the Paleolithic era, stone burrows, and settlements. The largest is the Tilman Burrows in the Hislaya district, with a height of 24 meters. Others are the Tilbashar Castle and Ruins in Ozeli District, and the Araban Castle and Burrows, and the Zincirli and Sakçagözü Burrows in the Araban District. Together with 26 tolmen dating back to the Bronze Age, Hasanoğlu, Hisar, and Elif mausoleums in Gaziantep, another touristic treasure which should be seen is the greatest sculpture workshop of the world, the Yesemek Open Air Museum in the Islaya district. In the historical site, which is dated back to the time of the Hittites, lots of sculptures were processed between the 14th and 17th centuries BC. Today, there are 300 sculptured drafts, reliefs, and architectural pieces on display. Another important cultural value of Gaziantep, which is listed as an important sculptured city, dates back to late Hittite era, is the ancient city of Karkamış, located in the Karkamış district on the Turkish-Syrian border. Some of the statues and reliefs from Karkamış are displayed in Gaziantep, but most of them are in the Ankara Archaeological Museum. Another touristic site of the region is Rumkale. It is assumed to have been built in the late Hittite era and located in the Yavuzeli district on the banks of the Euphrates. Built on a high hill that rises on the edge of the water, surrounded with sharp rocks, Rumkale is an important religious site due to the Barsamov Monastery and the Church of St. Narcis. You can visit Rumkale via boat. One of the most important historical, cultural, and touristic sites, and also one of the reasons for Gaziantep being called the City of Mosaics, is the ancient city of Belkıs Zeugma. The historical city was founded in 300 BC in the Nizip district, near the shores of Bilecik Dam Lake. We are home to the second largest mosaic museum in the world with its treasures. For Gaziantep. The most important uncovered Zeugma mosaics are Manenad, Poseidon in his carriage, Perseus and Andromeda, Persephone and Daedalus, the crowning of Aphrodite, and women in breakfast together, with a statue of Mars. The mosaics, stela, and other discoveries from the excavations are on display in the Archaeological Museum of Gaziantep. In the city of Zeugma, it is assumed that there are villas, pillared streets, various agora, temples, and other monuments under 3 or 4 meters of earth, waiting to be revealed with ongoing excavations. The municipality is currently working on the Zeugma Mosaic Museum and Cultural Center, which, when completed, will be the largest museum complex in the world. Gaziantep has been the home of many civilizations since ancient times and was always a place of fertile lands as well as a strategic location between Mesopotamia and the Mediterranean Sea. Called the Pearl of the Southeast, Gaziantep has a population of 1,560,000 and has 3 main central districts of Şahin Bey, Şehit Kamil, and Özeli, with 6 rural districts of Nizip, İslahiye, Araban, Yavuzeli, Nurdağ, and Karkamish. Gaziantep is located on the junction of the Mediterranean region and the southeastern Anatolia region. It has Şanlıurfa to the east, Osmaniye on the west, Hatay to the southwest, Kahramanmaraş to its northwest, Adıyaman to the northeast, and Kilis and Aleppo, Syria to the south. You can travel to Gaziantep by air, train, and motorway. And from Gaziantep, you can go to Syria, Iraq, and other countries of the Middle East by motorway. Gaziantep hosted the Byzantines, Seljuks, Beylik of Dulkadir, and Mamluks. Converted to Islam in 639 and was taken by the Ottomans in 1516. It became a central area in the region in terms of military and trade. After World War I, the city was occupied by English forces and then French forces. But Gaziantep resisted the French occupation for 11 months without any support. Starting from April 1st, 1920, the French were forced to abandon the city on December 25th, 1921, as a result of the resistance. The name of the city comes from the word Ayıntap, which means shining spring, city glowing like the sun, and the most beautiful. After the establishment of the Republic of Turkey, the city was awarded with the title of Gazi, an honorary title for war veterans for the unique resistance example against the French forces. Thus, the city got the name of Gaziantep. In commemoration of the legendary freedom resistance, there are many monuments within the city. These include a memorial of martyrs, the 14 Martyrs Monument, the Karayılan Monument, and the Şahin Bey Monument. You can watch the legendary Defense of Gaziantep, in which 6,317 people were killed. They receive the admiration and appreciation of everyone in the Gaziantep Museum of War. Another place that must be seen is the Gaziantep Museum of Archaeology, which contains cultural, historical, and touristic treasures of Gaziantep, which traces the region back to its prehistoric times. Also, the mosaics, a bronze statue of Mars, monumental stelas, and seals are being displayed in the museum, together with the world-famous Monadnock mosaic, the Gaia, or the Gypsy Girl mosaic. As one of the symbols of the city, you will see that the eyes of the girl in the Gaia, the Gypsy Girl mosaic, follow you from whichever angle you look at it. Besides the mosaics of Zeugma, there are several pieces from different time periods on display in the museum, such as bone and stoneware pieces from the Neolithic era, various items from the Copper and Bronze Ages, seals and tablets of Hittite writings, and various works of the Urartus, Hittites, Hellenistic, Roman, and Byzantine origins. The Gaziantep Museum of Archaeology is one of the rare museums of the world with chronological scenes, frescoes, and mosaics. Another important place to visit in the city is, of course, the Gaziantep Castle, which is among the best examples of castles in Turkey, which still stand today. Although the exact period of construction is unknown, there are pieces of information that suggest that it was built as a watchtower in the Roman era and expanded gradually to become as it is today during the days of Emperor Justinian of Byzantine. Landscape restoration done by the Gaziantep municipality around the castle includes several ruined hammams, cisterns, small mosques, and various buildings. In the Gaziantep houses, where traditional architectural form is preserved, a courtyard approach is the basic construction due to hot summers. Gaziantep streets, where two-story houses facing into a courtyard, which is called hayat, are narrow and rich in shadows. In some places, there are special structures which are called kabalta, with roads under the houses. The traditional Arabian houses, like the Abdul Qadir Chemistry House, Anatolia Houses, and Hasan Suzar Villa, are located in the oldest areas of the city of Şekeroğlu, Eyüpoğlu, and especially the Bey Quarters. These are being restored and taken under protection in forms of small hotels or museums. One of them is the Kale Boutique Hotel, which was restored by the Gaziantep municipality and is located on the outskirts of the castle. The three-story Hasan Suzar Villa, which was constructed over a cellar carved into a huge rock during the 19th century, has been restored and transformed into a museum. It serves as the Museum of Ethnography, where examples of traditional life and the culture of Gaziantep are displayed. Another traditional Antep house is serving as the Medusa Museum of Archaeological Glass Works and Culture Center. A traditional Antep house with 12 rooms, restored by the Şahin Bey municipality and currently serving as the Gaziantep Museum of War, where items from the Freedom War are on display and the animation Defense of Gaziantep is shown. Today, two examples of traditional Gaziantep architecture are also serving as museums. One is the first Islam museum of the region, the Foundation Museum of Gaziantep, Mevlevi Hanesi, in which Mevlevi culture and examples of calligraphic art are displayed. The other is Bayazhan, which is being restored by the Gaziantep municipality, and currently the Gaziantep City Museum and Cultural Center is open on the second floor. In this center, traditional clothing, handicrafts, baklava, a famous Gaziantep dessert, the weaving of famous Antep rugs, and Antep embroidery are on display. Also, information about traditional Gaziantep handicrafts, such as yemeni, which is a colored cotton kerchief, copper production, tin plating, silver, and nakre engraving, is given via short movies. Gaziantep hosts the modern facilities of city life, such as the Gaziantep Municipality, Gaziantep Governorate, Barrister's Chamber, an open-air theater, Chambers of Industry and Commerce, and the University of Gaziantep. Together with important public places that lead to the creation of traditional quarters, such as religious buildings, covered bazaars, hans, madrasas, and hammams. Castells, a kind of cistern, built by carving the underground rock in order to acquire water supplies for the city in the past, are another important symbol of Antep architecture. And visiting the Pishirici Mezgiri Kastili is strongly recommended. Gaziantep hammams were one of the important elements of social life. They were built with half of the structure buried into the ground in order to prevent heat loss. Naib Hammami, on the skirts of Gaziantep Castle, is one of the hammams that was restored by the Gaziantep Municipality and is open to public service. In the city center, where Kemikli and Zincirli Bedestans, or covered bazaars, are located, there are 18 historical buildings or bazaars, with most of them located on the courtyard side. Some of them are the Millet Han, Tuz Han, Kürkçü Han, Yeni Han, Elbeyli Han, Hızvı Han, Emir Ali Han. Some of these Hans have been restored, such as Bayaz Han, Sura Han, Tutun Han, Buday Han, and Pursefa Han. These restored Hans are being used by businesses today. In terms of religious tourism, Gaziantep is full of important places, although they do not function as such. Many churches and synagogues like Kindirli, Meryem Ana, Nizip, Fevkani, and Havra have been taken under protection. The ruined Church of St. Bedros is being restored by the Gaziantep Municipality and will be renamed the Ömer Ersoy Cultural Center. The historical mosques of Gaziantep are important architecturally in terms of their visual, functional, and social contributions. Their locations within the city and construction dates also make them important historically. During the defense of Gaziantep, only 30 mosques of 50 could be saved and survive today. The oldest mosques of the city are the Ömeriye, Boyacı, Eyüpoğlu, Sırvani, Kurtuluş, and Ali Nacar mosques. In the City of Saints, Gaziantep, which is surrounded by spiritual walls, like Ömer the Apostle, there are many tombs that belong to important religious figures,
like the prophet Yusa, a nephew of the prophet Moses, and five of the Sahibe, or people who saw the prophet Muhammad during his life. These are Sa'id ibn Ebu Waqqas, Okish, Kara Chomak, Pursefa, and Dawud Ejder. In terms of nature tourism, Gaziantep has much natural beauty. In the hot days of spring and summer, there are special events which are called Sayre. These are special hikes to the countryside to avoid the heat and noise of the city environment. On these hikes, picnic and excursion spots are the best places to go. Some of these are the Duluk Baba Forest, Ozele Karpuzatan, Kavakluk, Dutluk, Borch Forest, Borch Lagoon, Korkun, and Nizip Karpuzatan. In the city center, there is Kavakluk, which was organized as the 100th year Ataturk Culture Park. It serves as a place for hiking and an excursion spot. Besides Kavakluk, there are two other places that are being used for the same purpose. One is Masal Park, which was organized by the Gaziantep municipality. Inside the park are two sections with figures of heroes from Turkish folk tales, small statues, and water channels in which boat journeys are possible. Another place for touring is the zoo. Organized as the largest national park of Turkey, it contains more than 4,000 animals of 250 different species. In the city center, there are many recreational places and touring parks for the public and visitors, such as Kırkavesi, Tutunhan, Kale Boutique Hotel, and the Planetarium, which is under construction. Amongst them is Tamışkavesi, one of the symbols of the city. It has a history of 140 years and is considered a local meeting place. With the project of the Culture Road that was prepared by the Gaziantep municipality and starts from the castle, an important step has been taken for preserving many traditional handicraft and traditional arts, such as coppersmithing, silver and nakre embroidery, shoe cobbling, jewelry, rug weaving, pottery, aba, a coarse woolen cloth production, pack saddle production, and many others as a result of the restoration projects on this route. On this road, you can walk mystical streets and buy many interesting items from more than 300 shops, like Bakırcılar Çarşısı, Almacı Pazar, Atar Çarşısı, Hapapçı Çarşısı, Kenderci Çarşı, and Eskici Çarşısı. Gaziantep has many places for sightseeing and as its cultural heritage. Alongside these are such regional features as the local copperworks, mother of pearl inlays, walnut crafted gifts, kutno, a hand-woven cloth that was a favorite of the Ottoman sultans, Yemeni cobblers, and handmade Antep kilims. Gaziantep cuisine is known worldwide and must be added to these. There are 32 different kinds of kebab, 26 different types of meatloaf, 15 different types of stuffing, and overall, approximately 250 52 different types of meals in Gaziantep cuisine, all of which have a distinctive place among Turkish and world cuisines. This is due to the culmination of many various traditions, civilizations, and rich regional flavors. As a matter of fact, the first applied cuisine museum of Turkey, the Emine Gosh Cookery Museum, is located in Gaziantep. You can spend an enjoyable time tasting the local food and beverage in this place. The pistachio, which is known as the green diamond in Turkey, has such fame that it extends beyond the borders of the country. It is a powerful vitamin and energy source which contains all the basic food requirements for the human body. And of course, we cannot forget the most delicious of sweets, baklava. In the 2007-2008 educational year, 382,173 pupils within Gaziantep attended 734 official schools, 33 private schools, and 1,908 educational facilities. In the University of Gaziantep, which was founded in 1987, there are 7 faculties, 3 institutes, 4 vocational colleges, 6 vocational schools of higher education, and 12 research and application centers. In terms of health services, Gaziantep provides world standard health care by means of the University Hospital and other private hospitals that are also serving patients from Iraq and Syria. Regarding finance, Gaziantep is among the most leading cities of Turkey, and the city is a center of attraction, especially in the textile sector. Our production industry continuously develops itself with more than 9,000 brands and patent registrations. We are exporting to 141 countries around the globe. The hospitable people of Gaziantep, or the City of Mosaics, would be very pleased if you would like to come and experience all the beauties of our city, the pearl of the Southeast, with her cultural and historical treasures, alongside her health and education institutions. Await your discovery.